Hello! Welcome to the Viewmasters. Batman, Brave and the Bold, episode number 18, The Color of Revenge. My name is Joe.
My name is Eric.
Hello!
Hello!
Hello, listeners! Hello, all my buddies. Hello, Eric. Just getting my hellos in.
Alright. Anyone else you want to say hello to?
No, I would like to say hello to you.
I believe you've already done that.
I think a couple times now. I love this episode.
It was a fine episode. Yeah.
Anyway.
Cold open. Welcome to Atomic Batteries to Power.
What would be the title of the second episode if the first one is The Color of Revenge?
Ooh, shit.
Batman Breaks the Trends. No, I know, it's a slant rhyme. What rhymes with revenge? Fucking nothing.
Orin?
Or no? Robin makes amends. Nope. Still a slant rhyme.
Yeah. Take it to the edge. Nope.
Batman visits Stonehenge.
That'll have to do.
It's the only one.
Yep.
Oh, listeners, if you can think of a better title for the second part of this Batman 66 two-parter, remember, part one's called The Color of Revenge. Let us know. So the opening of the cold open is Batman 66.
Pretty much.
And it's great.
It's absolutely fantastic.
There's a bat signal.
Yep.
There's a red phone.
Yep.
There's a Shakespeare bust. There's poles. There's a rotating platform for the Batmobile.
There's a close-up of a turbine engine.
Mm-hmm. Of Batman and Robin putting their seatbelts on.
Yep. Because safety first, chum.
That's right. It made the Batmobile makes the same noise.
Yep.
When it revs up.
Yeah.
Like the exact same noise.
There's the hidden entrance to the cave with the road sign blocking it.
Mm-hmm.
There's the climbing up the side of a building.
Yeah.
It was all pretty much there.
It was spectacular.
Yep.
I liked that. So it was a flashback.
Yes.
To earlier in Batman's career, when he was partnered with a child Robin. At that point,
which child Robin?
Dick Grayson.
Okay,
I'm assuming.
All right.
Robin when he's young is what I mean to say.
Okay,
then. Child Robin.
I thought you were gonna actually like build up mystery as to. I wonder who it is that Batman has teamed up with in his early days.
I didn't think I needed to do that.
Okay.
Should I have done that?
No.
Do you want to go back?
No, I'm good.
Okay.
All right.
But yes, and I like that in the flashback, Batman does not have the yellow oval around the bat symbol on his chest.
Because that's what that means. It's early in his career.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's what that has always meant.
Yep. It will never change.
It's just confusing if current Batman doesn't have the oval around his chest. Because I don't know if I'm reading a flashback or a modern age story. That's how I always tell the difference.
Well, now the way you can tell is if he has stupid purple ribbing all over his armor now.
That's right. Yeah. Good call.
Yeah. In the worst redesign of a costume that there has ever been since Superman.
Yep. But yeah, so it's a flashback to a Batman and Robin adventure.
Yeah, it's a simpler time.
Yes.
When it was totally okay to have young children be your sidekick.
That's right.
And you know what? I say that time never should have gone away.
I like it.
Yep, me too.
Enjoy it.
Yep.
I've always had a fondness for Robin. I don't know why.
I know why.
Why?
Well, I mean, I can only speak for myself.
Okay. About you. Okay.
But I will give you my
reasons. I thought you were going to tell me why I like Robin.
Because you're gay.
Well, that's right. No, I'm not.
Nope. Yeah. You've just been lying to yourself.
Are you reading my mind right now?
Yep.
Am I full gay?
You're full gay.
Why do you like Robin?
All right. So I have held this theory for a very long time.
Okay.
Because Nightwing, the aforementioned Richard Grayson,
mm-hmm.
has long been my favorite DC Comics character.
Yeah. More than Blue Beetle.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yep.
I did not know that.
All right. It's a close battle.
Yeah.
Yeah. But Blue Beetle actually falls into this as well.
Okay.
Superman, you know, is very much considered like the first superhero.
Mm-hmm.
Then Batman, you know, was right up behind him there.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
They're both
coming
pretty much
in the rear,
huh?
Coming up in Batman's rear.
Coming up Superman's in Batman's rear. But you have basically like, you know, two major archetypes of superhero.
Yeah.
You have, you know, Superman being the bright, you know, primarily colored, you know, public, you know, face of superheroes. And you mm-hmm. have Batman as sort of the dark, gritty underside of superheroes.
Yeah.
And then you have Robin, who yeah. is kind of like the go-between the two.
Okay.
So he basically is a third archetype that has pretty much been used for almost every other superhero character out there, such as Spider-Man, Blue Beetle, even Daredevil.
Okay.
Even down to the costume coloring.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
And so that is why those three characters, and I would say even Wonder Woman, falls into that Robin category.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Interesting. Because it's neither extreme.
Right.
Okay.
Because he was kind of brought in to soften Batman a little
mm-hmm.
bit.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. I actually think I like Robin, or I did when I was a kid. I was really into Robin.
Mm-hmm.
Partly because of the Adam West Batman show.
Sure.
I thought he was awesome.
Right.
and also, I was getting into comics. My parents got me like one of those little bundles that sure. had three comics in it, like three Batman comics. And one of them was, Batman 416, which is the, first meeting of Jason Todd and Dick Grayson. And it detailed a lot of the history of how Dick Grayson, you know, he started off as Robin and then he stopped being Robin and he grew up and then he went off on his own and then yeah. he became Nightwing. And just like all of that history stuff, I thought that was awesome, and it made me really interested in reading all of those old comics where, oh man, Dick Grayson is Robin in this? That must be really old.
Right.
And so, like, it always just sort of had an interest for me in that respect. And then I really, like, I sort of read comics casually, and then I really got into it around when Tim Drake became Robin.
Right.
So yeah, just a lot of my major comic reading events have been tied to Robin.
That's cool. Because I also had that same three-pack.
Yeah.
That's with my mom
414, 415, 416?
Yep.
Awesome.
So, yeah, I have read that issue, too. Probably, I mean, not my first Batman comic, but, you know, among the first, I think.
Yeah.
Because when I was growing up, you know, my mom would, you know, buy me just random comics.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there was no such thing as, you know, buying consecutive issues.
Right. It was weird. It was like they told stories that were self-contained.
Right. You didn't necessarily need to get that next issue.
Yeah.
It really would be
weird.
Cool if you did.
Yeah.
Because there was another great story coming up.
Yeah.
But you weren't usually left with some sort of, you know, story that did end.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was cool.
Yeah.
Though I remember that three-pack, issue 415 was a Millennium crossover, and it begins with, like, Batman and Robin fighting Commissioner Gordon, and he's a robot, and Robin shoots him with a shotgun, and it's just really weird, and it doesn't tie into anything at all. And then I think later on there's a scene where Robin is like, following the Scarecrow,
right,
and he ends up dousing the Scarecrow with a bunch of fear gas and making him just completely insane, and like all of it was connected to nothing,
right?
So I always thought that was weird when I was a kid, like, why doesn't any of this make sense? But then the very next issue, everything made perfect sense,
right,
because it's all self-contained.
Yep. But yeah, I've always enjoyed Robin as well. You know, definitely grew up with, you know, Dick Grayson being Robin, which is actually weird because in the early 80s, when my mom was buying me random comics, the Batman ones that she did had Jason Todd.
Yeah.
But Jason Todd has never been my Robin, nor will he ever.
Yeah, I think Tim Drake is my Robin.
Tim Drake, he's not my Robin, but he's definitely my favorite Robin.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I do like Dick Grayson better as Nightwing.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, I've always got a soft spot for a Robin. Even Damian Wayne grew on me.
I like Damian Wayne a lot.
It's pretty much just Jason Todd who is better as a corpse.
I think that Jason Todd was a really good idea for a character that was really poorly executed, and people hated it because it was really poorly executed, so they killed him.
Yeah.
Could have been done really, really well, really interestingly. Like, today, maybe, it would work better. And sort of Damian Wayne does some of that.
He does, and then there was the animated version of Tim Drake.
Yeah.
Which was essentially the
Jason Todd,
but done correctly.
Yeah.
And also, you know, when I started, you know, I'm like one of the oldest comics that I still own, at least, you know, from my childhood.
Yeah.
You know, again, it's a Jason Todd issue, but, you know, it's back when he basically was just, redheaded Dick Grayson.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Pre-crisis. Yep. Dick Grayson ripoff Jason Todd.
Yep.
Yeah.
Circus kid whose parents died, but he had red hair.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. I always liked that about Jason Todd.
Yeah. I really liked it, because, you know, the whole bringing him back from the dead is also about the most retarded thing that has ever happened in Batman.
Yeah.
But I did like when Grant Morrison made him, well, I mean, he became the Red Hood when he came back. But Grant Morrison actually gave him a distinct and recognizable costume.
Mm-hmm.
And also gave him his red hair back.
Yeah, I like that too.
Yeah.
Because it all happened.
Yep. He's a big fan of that.
Yeah, that's definitely.
Pretty much the only time I've ever liked Jason Todd.
It's a good thing, then, that it was quickly abandoned.
Yep. Super quickly.
Fucking immediately.
Well, like an issue later. Like as soon as Grant Morrison turned his back.
Yeah. Thanks, Joe Winnick.
Sadly happens pretty much to every Grant Morrison book ever.
Yeah. That's why I stop reading books after Grant Morrison leaves.
It's for the best.
Anyway,
yeah.
Batman and Robin team up in the beginning. Well, they're not really teaming up because they're a duo.
They are a duo.
A dynamic duo. Yeah. And they are called by the commissioner to stop Crazy Quilt.
Yes.
Who is stealing a doohickey from the Museum of Doohickey Art.
All these motherfuckers stealing doohickeys.
I know.
And he's stealing it from Exposition Hall.
Yes. What a dick. And he didn't even tell us why.
Nope. Or even what it does.
Yeah.
Or maybe he did have stuff in.
Hey, me might have.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, but it's a thing that he can use to shoot colors at people.
Yeah, pretty much. harmful colors.
Hard light. Yep. It's a Green Lantern ring, actually. It uses the emotions of rage, hope, and willpower to attack people. Because it's red, blue, and green.
Yep.
For the listener. Batman and Robin easily defeat his henchman, the Color Guard. There's a sequence of them just, you know, running around trying to get away from the light gun.
Yep. Robin saves the day by, having it reflect off of a mirror.
Mm-hmm.
And, blinds Crazy Quilt.
Yeah, it reflects, right back into his eyes.
Yep.
And blinds him.
Yep. And thus is the origin of Daredevil.
That's right. And that's the end of the cold open.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this is the first time that, I think this show has acknowledged Robin.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
And so that's awesome.
Yeah, I like that too.
Yeah. So what's the main story?
It's weird. It's Batman and Robin versus Crazy Quilt.
What? But that just happened.
I know.
We just watched that.
It is happening again.
Why?
It is happening again.
Yeah. This is one of the rare episodes where the cold open continues into the regular story.
Yeah.
But years have passed.
Mm-hmm.
God knows how many.
Yeah, probably like 10, I guess. Is my guess.
I don't know. It's a long time. Just enough time for Robin to be a bitter dick.
That's right.
Literally.
He is a bitter Richard Grayson.
Yep.
No, Robin's all grown up now.
Yep.
He is wearing the Earth 2 adult Robin costume.
Yeah.
Which is awesome. And kind of terrible.
Mostly terrible.
Yeah. Designed by Neil Adams.
It is not a great costume.
It's not Neil Adams' best design work for a Robin costume.
No. That, again, falls to Tim Drake.
That's right.
I'm pretty sure that is the best Robin costume.
Yeah,
I agree. I mean, I do have a fondness for the classic.
Yeah. But yeah, no, I think the Tim Drake costume is probably the best.
Yeah.
Yeah, the original Tim Drake costume, not the
right,
the all red and black one.
Right.
Which, that one's cool, too.
Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah. So Robin has grown up. He is wearing pants now.
Yep.
And he is protecting Bloodhaven.
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 Blood.
There are no umlauts to be found in this episode.
Yes, there are.
Are there?
Yeah.
I didn't see the umlauts over the U.
Yep.
Okay.
At the climax of the episode.
Yeah.
When they go to Bloodhaven Textile.
Yeah. You mean Bloodhaven Textile? Because it all runs together.
Yes, it does. It took me a while to figure out what the hell that was trying to say. I was like, what is Haven't Textile?
Haven't X Tile.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's actually a tile and grout company. No, redo your bathroom.
Yay.
With blood.
Blood. The B-L-U-D with the umlauts is over the Haven.
I did not see the umlauts.
Yeah,
all right.
It was there.
They pronounce it Bloodhaven.
Yes, they do.
In the show, because they are not German. They are Americans.
I know. So can I just say that in the comics, when Nightwing got his own series and moved to Bloodhaven,
yeah,
that I was like, this is the worst thing ever.
Yeah.
This is the dumbest fucking fake city name that has ever been in DC Comics.
Yeah, I've never cared for that city name.
Right.
I like the idea of Nightwing going off to his own city.
Sure.
And, you know, Gotham, but worse.
Right.
Just down the river.
Yep, because that's where all the bodies wash up.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Something. In the Haven of Bloods.
Yep.
Yeah.
Worst thing ever.
Brother Blood really missed an opportunity, never setting up shop there.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe they'll have that happen in Arrow.
I hope so.
Because Brother Blood's been on.
Right, yeah. Arrow spends a lot of time fighting Teen Titans villains, at least in the first two seasons.
He does.
Yeah.
It's weird. Well, he does have a Teen Titan on the show.
So. No, not anymore, spoilers.
What?
Are you behind on Arrow?
I'm a little behind.
Oh, okay. Well, I spoiled something for you, then.
Okay.
No. I apologize.
Yeah, it's fine. I kind of don't care.
I know, like, I keep watching Arrow, but I don't really enjoy it.
Yeah.
At least compared to The Flash. The Flash is so much better.
Did you watch last night's episode?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I made a tweet in the middle of watching it that got no response whatsoever. Joe and Cisco go to Starling City.
Yeah.
And run into, I don't know his name.
Yeah, Paul Blackthorne.
Yeah, that guy. And Laurel.
Yeah, Captain Lance.
Captain Lance.
Whatever his first name is, yep. I don't know.
And Laurel.
And Laurel.
And just seeing them interact with Flash characters, I was just like, you know, because that also happened last week.
Mm-hmm.
I think that the entire show of Arrow is better served just being Flash supporting characters.
Yeah. Every Arrow character is better on The Flash.
Yep.
Yeah. 100%.
Because I did not hate Laurel.
Yeah.
For the first time ever.
Well, she had fun.
Yeah.
She smiled.
Yeah.
It was weird.
It was super weird and fun and awesome.
Yeah.
And even Paul Blackthorne was pretty good.
Yeah.
I mean, he's all right.
Is it Quentin Lance?
Quentin!
Yeah.
That's it.
Quentin Choir Lance.
Yep. Quentin Tarantino Choir Lance. Yeah. They should just cancel Arrow.
Yes.
Fold it into The Flash.
Yeah.
And just have them appear, like, every five episodes.
I like it.
Yeah.
Let's do this. Actually, Oliver can stay on his own show.
Okay. Yeah. All right, I'm with you.
Yeah. Everybody else. Moving to Central City.
Yep. Like, yeah, they even make it a storyline where they're just fed up with Oliver.
Yeah. Definitely. Done. Yeah. Yeah. Join the crowd, guys. Join the audience. Yeah. What were we talking about?
This show.
Yeah, Bloodhaven.
Bloodhaven.
Yes. And, that's right, Teen Titans villains.
Teen Titans.
Brother Blood.
But Batman, Mervin the Bold.
Yeah.
Robin.
Robin is patrolling Bloodhaven. He fights Solomon Grundy, gangster.
Yep.
Stops him from robbing a bank. And then immediately... I did like the Robin signal. In this episode.
Yep.
Which is the bat signal, but with the giant R.
Sure.
That was awesome.
Yeah. And then, he defeats Solomon Grundy, and he rides off into the sunset, and then there's a giant eye in the sky blinking.
Yeah.
It's weird.
It's super weird. And never explained.
Nope.
I mean, we get that it's sort of connected to the other stuff that's gonna happen.
Right.
But no explanation for how it got there.
Nope.
For why it's there.
He's weird. He sees it and doesn't even question that it's bizarre.
He's just like, oh, that's weird.
Yeah.
I wonder what that's about.
And then Batman shows up and explains it.
Batman shows up. Batman ex machina.
So he's a sexy robot lady?
Yes, he's a sexy robot lady who talks to machines and is the mayor of New York.
Sweet.
Batman shows up and is like, hey, Crazy Quilt's back. You're my sidekick now.
Yep.
Again. Do everything I tell you to do.
Yeah. Batman's a dick.
He is kind of a dick in this episode.
Even though he's a Bruce, he's a real dick.
Yeah. But it's Robin's a dick, too.
Yep.
Yeah.
His name is Dick Grayson.
He acts like a dick.
In
this episode.
He's a spoiled little shit.
I mean, I don't know if he's spoiled.
An entitled little shit.
Yes. Yeah, I'll give you that.
All right.
Entitled works. Yeah, he's intent on proving that he's his own man, and doesn't mind telling you constantly
right.
that he's his own man.
You know what steps might be taken to prove that to us, Robin?
Become Nightwing?
I was just going to say maybe a different costume altogether.
Yeah.
But becoming Nightwing is a much better option.
Yeah. Yeah. Because it is a different costume.
Yeah.
He's got pants on.
Sure.
But he's still Robin.
He is still Robin. And the colors are pretty much the same.
Yeah.
It is basically the Robin costume, but with leggings.
Yeah. Yeah. Again, awesome. Not really awesome.
No, yeah.
But maybe more of a clean break. So yeah. You need their Dickie.
Although maybe he would be better off as Owlman.
Maybe. Yeah. They won't know he's really Robin.
Yep. Or maybe he could have gotten the other Earth 2 Robin costume.
He could have. The one that's a Batman costume with a Robin cape?
Yep. Got a big red R over the bat.
That's right.
Yep. And no bat mask.
Right. Yeah. That's right. He does have the mask that's it's the domino mask, but it's a bat.
Yep.
Oh, that is inspired design work.
Let's just throw everything together.
Yeah.
And say it's new.
But yeah, so they are tracking Crazy Quilt, and Batman is warning Robin that Crazy Quilt is out for revenge for Robin having blinded him. And that's pretty much the thrust of the episode.
Pretty much. They're fighting Crazy Quilt, and Robin is whining.
Mm-hmm.
And Batman's just being Batman.
Yeah.
Although slightly worse.
Yeah, because he's just a jerk.
Yep.
Not paying attention to Robin.
Yep.
When he's having, you know, legitimate thoughts and ideas.
Yep. Then Batman and Robin save the day, and then, like, the cops all rush over to Batman to thank him.
Yeah.
You know, it's not a good day for Robin.
Definitely not.
But Robin also reacts poorly to everything.
He does. He is a sore loser.
Yep. Yeah. But admittedly, he's, how old do you think he is here?
Well, I think that in the opening scene, he's probably 10.
Okay, so
about 20? So he's about 20 here, yeah. Is what I'm thinking.
You're a 20-year-old, and all of a sudden you have to ride in the sidecar of the Bat-cycle.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like, why couldn't a Batman even just brought the Batmobile?
Yeah,
that's true. That would be even better.
That's true.
But no, he brought the Batcycle just to humiliate Robin.
Or there's space on the back of the Batcycle. He could have
ridden bitch.
Him back.
Yeah.
Okay, that's worse. I just thought it'd be really cool to ride in a sidecar.
I thought so.
I think probably again from the Adam West Batman show.
Probably, yeah. I'd ride in a sidecar.
Yeah.
I knew I wouldn't die. I think that would be my constant fear about riding in a any kind of motorcycle, be it the sole driver of a motorcycle or riding in the sidecar.
Yeah.
It is just the fear of constant death.
I'm sure there's nothing to protect you.
Nope.
Though I feel like a sidecar probably adds some stability.
I would assume.
To a motorcycle.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
Yeah. I would still just be deathly afraid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It'd just be too stressful.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be able to enjoy it.
Yep.
This episode is sort of an adaptation of an old comic.
Okay.
Batman 316.
Okay.
Was
John 316?
Yes. Yes, for Batman so loved the world that he gave us his only son Robin to blind Crazy Quilts and then fight him. That's how that goes. No, Batman 316 is after Robin has left the title, and he comes back as a guest star, and it's a Crazy Quilt story. Crazy Quilt wants revenge on Robin for having blinded him in a previous story, and that was one of the first older Dick Grayson Robin comics that I read, so I have very distinct memory of that.
Yeah,
and I always thought that Crazy Quilt was sort of Crazy Quilt was sort of Robin's archenemy,
right?
At least pre-crisis, because there was that story, and then Jason Todd's first full storyline as Robin is a Crazy Quilt story as well. Huh. Crazy Quilt thinks that Jason Todd is Dick Grayson, and so he's trying to kill him.
Well, sure,
yeah. Because it's just the costume.
Yeah, right. Everyone should just always assume that Batman's just always had the one Robin.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Yep. And there's only ever been one Batman.
Yeah. Yep. So this is cool for me in that respect.
That's awesome. Did it live up to the comic?
I don't remember a ton about the comic.
Okay.
Other than I really liked it when I was a kid. I haven't read it in probably 15 years. Yeah. The episode was great. What's that?
I said it'd be probably better if you didn't.
Probably. I don't know. It might be good.
Maybe I'll look at it.
Maybe I'll look for it at a con or something.
Let us know.
I will.
All right. You're going to a big con next weekend?
This weekend, yeah. Keep an eye out for it.
All right, then.
This episode was great.
Yeah.
I really liked it.
Our big villain, Crazy Quilt, is voiced by Jeffrey Tambor.
Yeah.
Which is pretty awesome.
That is great.
Yeah.
What else has he done?
Trans America?
Transparent.
Transparent.
Okay, yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
What am I thinking of?
Trans America was a movie with Felicity Huffman.
Oh, okay. Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Arrested Development.
The rap band.
The rap band, exactly. Right, yeah, he was a member of Arrested Development.
Yep. Three's Company.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, the other rap bands.
Yep.
Yeah. Was he on Three's Company?
I believe he was.
Was he really? I didn't know that.
Yeah. I think he just had a recurring guest role kind of thing.
Was he Larry Furley?
He was not Larry Furley.
Was he Larry Furley's dad?
He was not Larry Furley's dad.
I don't know who he is.
There is no Larry Furley in that show.
Who's no Mr. Furley? There's
Mr. Furley.
And then there's Larry.
There's Larry.
Yep. Was he the Regal Beagle?
He was not the Regal Beagle. That's your dog.
That is my dog. She's a pain in the ass beagle. You know what I mean?
I mean,
she's a pain in the ass.
Yeah. I think he was like a dentist.
Yeah.
That would occasionally just show up and be a foil for Jack.
That's weird.
Yeah. or maybe he was. He was in the Ropers spinoff.
Oh wow. Okay.
Yeah.
You sure there's not a Larry Furley?
There's no Larry Furley. No,
okay.
Mr. Furley, played by Don Knotts.
Yeah.
And Larry.
What was Larry's last name?
I don't know. I don't think he ever had one.
Not Furley?
Yeah, not Furley.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be a crazy twist?
That would be a crazy twist.
It's related to Mr. Furley.
He's his long lost son.
Yeah, and they never knew it.
Nope. Yeah, and I'd just like to say this right now.
Yeah.
I miss John Ritter.
Yeah, I do too. He was great.
Jason Ritter, you are fine, but you are no John Ritter.
No, he's not. Yeah. Because they're different people.
Yes, they are. But they are related.
They are related, yes.
And as I learned recently, Jason Ritter, huge Nirvana fan.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
How did you learn that?
Because he was a guest on Spontanea Nation.
Okay, is that a podcast?
It is Paul Tompkins' improv podcast.
Nice. All right.
We'll check it out.
Okay. No, you shut up. That's another thing that he does.
Yes, it is. I've yet to ever see it.
I've never seen that either. I don't get the network that's on.
I don't either.
Anyway.
Okay. They're all on YouTube, I guess.
Are they?
But okay. I don't want to watch internet videos.
Yeah. Are you watching Community?
I am.
On Yahoo Screen?
No.
No?
No.
Are you acquiring it?
I am acquiring it.
Yeah?
Yes.
It's fucking great.
It's very good.
I love it. It's still as good.
It is very good.
Good as ever.
I mean, so far, my favorite episode has been the one where Chang and Annie are in the adaptation of The Karate Kid.
Yes!
Because Jason Mantzoukas is a goddamn national treasure.
He really is. I know he's Greek or whatever,
yep,
but he's all American.
Yep.
He's a goddamn national treasure. And I would tell that to him on Twitter, but he's not.
He's not on Twitter. I really like the one where they get the virtual reality
that was also
thing and like I installed new floodlights in our backyard and the first time I turned them on I was like Jesus wept. And Jenny just walked away.
As well she should.
Batman Brave and the Bold. Brave. I really like this one.
I did as well. It was enjoyable.
Yeah. Check it out, kids.
Yep.
Bye.
We'll be back next week. Goodbye.
Thank you for listening to The Viewmasters. You can subscribe to the show directly at view.guttertrash.net or at iTunes and leave us a review. Visit view.guttertrash.net for email information and links to Facebook and Twitter. We'll see you next time on The Viewmasters.